Cash Management Unit tab. This tab is used to move funds from the branch to and from correspondent bank. Here, the vault account is defaulted and the account to be credited or debited is inputted, including the bank's reference if available at the cash transfer to field and commit the deal. Transfer to correspondent bank. Step 1. Click on Cash Management Unit. Step 2. Click on Cash Transfer to Correspondent Bank. Step 3. In Local Amount Transfer field, type in the required amount. Step 4. Type the account number into the Correspondent Bank Account Number field. Step 5. Type the branch vault account number in the branch account number field. Step 6. Type in the date in the value date field or click the drop-down tab to select the date from the calendar. Step 7. Type in the narration field. Step 8. Click on the validate tab. Step 9. Enter the denomination. Step 10. Click on Validate tab and if no error occurs, click on Commit tab to complete the transfer. Step 11. Input your TTID into the Cash Transfer to Correspondent Bank field. And lastly, Step 12. Click on Perform an action on the correct Contract tab and click Audit tab. Note, always check all your transaction if it's authorized by using Transfer Transaction ID, the TTID. Transfer from correspondent bank. Receiving cash from corresponding bank. Here is the process of receiving cash from the corresponding bank. Step 1. Click on Cash Management Unit. Step 2. Click on Receiving Cash from Correspondent Bank. Step 3. Type in the amount in the Local Amount Transfer field. Step 4. Type in the account number in the Corresponding Account Number field. Step 5. Type the branch account number in the Branch Account Number field. Step 6. Type in the date in the value date field or click the drop-down tab to make use of the calendar. Step 7. Type in the narration field. Step 8. Click on the validate tab. Step 9. Enter the denomination details in the unit field. And lastly, Step 10. Click on Validate tab and if there is no error, proceed by clicking on the Commit tab to complete the transfer. The teller. The teller performs most of the transactions in the bank. The following screen shows what the teller can do in the teller menu and how to achieve the tasks. Deposits tab. Various types of deposit transactions are carried out here, such as cash deposits, school fees, collection and remittances, suspense cash deposits, check deposits, to mention a few among others. To make deposits transaction, click the application for the type of deposit required. Cash deposit to self. To perform a cash deposit to self, please take the following steps. Step 1. Click on Cash Deposit to self. Step 2. Type in the required account number in the credit account field. Step 3. Type the amount in the amount field. Step 4. Type the deposit slip number in the deposit slip number field. Step 5. type the depositor's phone number in the right field. Step 6. Click on the Validate tab. Step 7. Click the unit to enter the denomination. And lastly, Step 8. Validate again. If no errors, then click on Commit tab to complete the transaction. Note: ensure that you fill all the mandatory fields. Repeat steps for other operations and supply the respective unique numbers, for example, check numbers. Specify the charge if required and select No as Waive Charges option. Third party deposit or stamp duty. Please be advised that there is a charge of 50 naira on a third party deposit. This charge is called the processing fee or stamp duty, and it is active only if the deposit amount is 1,000 naira and above. Step 1. Click on cash deposit by third party. Step 2. Type in the required account number in the credit account field. Step 3. Type the amount in the amount field. Step 4. Type the deposit slip number in the deposit slip number field. Step 5. Type the depositor's phone number in the right field. Step 6. Click on Validate tab. Step 7. Click the unit to enter denomination. And lastly, Step 8. Validate again if no errors. Then click on Commit tab to complete the transaction. Payment of school fees. Payment of school fees can be carried out like a deposit by providing the various school account numbers. Details of payments are inputted in the narration field. This field can be multi-valued to accommodate more details. Step 1. Click on school fees. Step 2. Type in the required account number in the credit account field. Step 3. Type the amount in the amount field. Step 4. Type in narration. Step 5. Type in the value date. Step 6. Click the expand multi-value. Note: this allows you to add more than one account, but all accounts must belong to one customer. T24 customers may have more than one account, as it is customer-centric. Step 7. Click on the Validate tab. Step 8. Click the unit to enter denomination. And lastly, Step 9. Validate again. If no errors, then click on Commit tab to complete the transaction. Collection and remittance. Collection and remittance for bills. You credit the collection and remittance account with the respective amount. Step 1. Click on Collection and Remittance. Step 2. Type in the required account number in the credit account field. Step 3.